Welcome to CB Linguistics 101. I am your instructor and tutor for the day, the Black Wolf. Now, I would like you to all know that what we are going to discuss in this class is the simple linguistics commonly used by truck drivers. Now, these are things you may hear on a CB radio. The CB radio is abbreviated for Citizens Band. Now, I know you're anxious to get started, so without further ado, let us progress immediately into this fun and in-depth world. Now, let us start off simple with simple terms of the road. I'm sure you are all familiar with a road that looks like this. Yes, it is your standard four-lane highway, but there are some few little different terms. Now, please note that there are different terms for the different lanes. The right lane, as you see it there, is known as the gravy lane. This is the lane where the drivers are traveling at a leisurely speed because they do not necessarily have any need to be anywhere in a hurry. Now, the left lane, it is what is known as the hammer lane. That is where drivers do what they call putting the hammer down. That means they are stepping on the accelerator to speed up as fast as they can go because they are in a hurry. Now, you will notice the white line dividing the two lanes. That is known as the zipper. Now, when you hear someone say that someone is not paying attention and is wandering over that zipper, that is what they mean. Now, you will also notice the small grassy area between the two directions of travel. This is known colloquially in CB lingo as the comedian. It is the center area that divides the lanes, more commonly called by us normal people as a median. However, truck drivers for some reason keep finding it humorous to call it the comedian because they're laughing at all the vehicles that have crashed into such said grassy area. Now, not all interstates have a comedian. Some of them have a divider such as this, made of concrete or metal. These concrete ones that are temporary, such as so, are known as K-rails. Now, the more permanent structure that you see dividing four lanes of traffic or more, such as in this instance, are known as Jersey barriers. Now, the purpose of such a barrier as this would to be keeping cars from, say, straying off the roadway into a dangerous hill or embankment, or to keep them from accidentally crossing over into opposite lanes of traffic. These are more often used in larger cities to prevent severe head-on collisions. Now that we've discussed some of the things you may see out on the highway, so you know what you're talking about with the road at least, let's get into some of the terminology about the things you see on the highway that drivers will talk about, so that you can get a better understanding and perhaps not be a total jackass and hold them up. Let's take a look. Now, the first thing we are going to discuss today is what is commonly referred to as a bear. Now, you may be driving down the road and suddenly hear someone say, "Ah, breaker, buddy, we got a big bear sitting on your side looking for you." Well, what they're talking about when they say a big bear or a full grown, as it is more commonly called, is not one of these. No. Indeed, they are talking one of these, a state police officer, commonly referred to as a smoky bear. Now, when you see them, they are looking for speeders. When they say sitting on your side, they do not mean you have a bear having a picnic on your side of the highway. They mean that this officer is using his radar to clock the speed of travel of your direction of traffic. Now, another thing you might hear drivers speak of from time to time is seat covers. Oh, this is something that most drivers enjoy looking for, but what you commonly think of as a seat cover is not what they are talking about. No, they are referring to one of these. Yes, a fine young lady in a nice car. Unfortunately, having been a driver for many years, I know you don't get to see this often, but rather, you see this all the time. It is not glamorous, it is not as lovely, but it is what you commonly see out here. I know, it's absolutely dreadful. I apologize. But I'm letting you know the truth. I'm letting you get into the world of the drivers. Now, let us explore some of the different types of bears. We've mentioned the Smoky Bear, but there are a couple others that we need to bring to light so that you understand, so that perhaps you can avoid trouble while speeding down the motorway. Now, this is what you would call a black wrapper. It is a state police car, but it does not have the late bars or markings of any of the normal police cars you would see. That is what you call them. You refer to them as a wrapper by the color of the car. Like this would be a blue wrapper. And my, you could almost say this is a black and blue wrapper. Quite a bad joke, I know. I apologize, but little bit of humor for your fun. Now, there is other types of police officers besides the state patrol officers, such as the county mountie. No, not that, you fool! The other picture! Yes, this, it's a county police car. These are the local boys that work for the county you might be driving through. And lastly, there is a yokel. Did I say that right? A local yokel. Oh, gosh, my language is horrible. No, not the hillbilly, you idiot! Ugh! This one, the local city police car. They work for the city in which you would be driving through. What are you doing, you idiot? I told you, check the pictures before we put... Never mind. I don't want to know. I'm not... I want to thank you for joining us today. It's been a real pleasure spending this first lesson with you. We will have more lessons coming up. Our next lesson, we will be addressing the names that drivers have for each other on the radio. We will be addressing such things as the portable parking lot, the salt shaker, and of course the ever-popular suicide jockey. I hope you've enjoyed your time with us, and I look forward to seeing you for our next lesson. Bye-bye.